I am. I need everyone to start taking their seats. And we're going to get this started. Everyone in the back. Okay, we're ready to start. On behalf of the Bruce Bass Inner City Band, I want to welcome each and every one of you. Thank you so much for coming. I am Sass Lewis, and I have the fun privilege of promoting Inner City Energy Band. And it's always a good time, and it's always good music. As our great friends. And this is a special night because this is the inaugural performance of the Rhythms of the Night music series. So you're in for a special treat. And my goodness, we have people here from everywhere. We have the beautiful lady here from Denmark. Yes! We have Atlanta. Oh my, Ohio. New York, of course, the hometown of the Bass is Massachusetts, Michigan, Texas, Portugal, Alabama, Tennessee,
Tampa,
oh, I'm coming, Orlando, Idaho, Punta Gorda, Daytona, all look so beautiful and handsome. Thank you so much. Bruce and Alicia want me to let each of you know that they wholeheartedly thank you for your support over the years. You come back, and just know that they truly appreciate you guys. And I want you to know that Bruce and Alicia took their time for this performance, and they put their hearts into it. They put their energy into it. They did everything they could to make sure that you guys would have a great time and feel special. So I want you to relax, and I want you to enjoy this show. And with that, I'm going to bring in our master of ceremonies, who is a very special person in my life, my husband, Addison Bruce Lewis, who some of you know as Daddy Lou. I give the mic up to you, Daddy.
Outside of Jehovah and my daughter, best thing you ever happened to. Welcome, everybody. And you know what we want to do? First thing, she's thanked and welcomed and everyone. We want to thank the staff here at the Crown Plaza Hotel. Katie and her crew, you know, they've been doing a great job. We like the place. Right now, we're thinking about coming back here next year for the second inaugural piece of the Rhythm of the Night performance. But we'll see how it works out. Yeah, it worked. So far, so good. They've been great. We've asked for things, and they've done it. And so we're very happy with them so far. And we're glad you're here. We're glad you're here. Folks, that's it. From all over the place. Barbados. You live in Barbados right now?
No.
Where do you live? Probably around the corner, right? I live on Tampa. South Tampa.
Well, hey.
Guyana?
Yeah!
You need me right now?
No!
Hey, that's all right. Welcome, welcome. We went to Guyana. That's pretty good. I'm from Philadelphia myself. You know, where's my Philly crap? Come on, push it, come on. West Philadelphia, yeah, Brooklyn, and Brady, and on the playground, and the day, chilling out, max, and relaxing off. Yeah. West Philly, that's me. That's me. In fact, you know, if you cut me right now, I'll be green for my best in the football, Philadelphia Eagles. Best record in football. Who's got a better record?
Steelers!
Three losses. We only have two. We only have two losses. So bring it. Come on. Bring it. Come on, Cletus. Come on. Walk over, lift back. Come on, guys. Come on. So we are glad you're here. We're glad you're here. You know, did anybody have any damage from Irma? Some damage, yeah. I mean, that was a terrible storm. Some damage done to the concrete roof, right? And so talking to the insurance adjuster, and he says, well, you know what? You can't cover that because that's wind damage. You have storm coverage, you don't have wind coverage. I'm going, what? A windless storm. Only windless storm I know is the quiet storm. You know, come on, man. And then they want a deductible. I hate deductibles anyway. I mean, you have insurance for years and years. You're paying for it, right? So one time you have an accident, what do they want? A deductible. I said, deduct it from all the money I've been paying for all these years. Come on, man. Don't make me happy. I went over to Aldi's, and you know Aldi's has the shopping cart. You got to pay 25 cents for it, right? To me, why? Why do I pay 25 cents for a shopping cart when I'm coming to the store and buying groceries? And they said it's because they don't want all the homeless people stealing the shopping carts. And I'm thinking, I'm going, who are the one people that got changed? It's the homeless folks, right? They're off in the corner. After you come by, they take all the change, you go out your car, they got quarters. They can take all the shopping carts they want. Now I'm begging for $5. You know, it's something, but come on. Makes no sense. You know, another thing that makes sense to me. People, and some of y'all might be, I'm not trying to be insulting, but people that have to walk their dogs and pick up after them. In my community, they have that. You have to pick up after your dog. And that's a good thing, I guess, because I don't have a dog. So, but what gets me is that people out there in the rain and the cold, taking their dogs out for a walk, can they pick that stuff up and carry it back in the house? And I'm thinking the dog got me going. A nice, comfortable home to go out here for me to do my business. You take it back in the house. Why not just do it in the house? You just won't stay in here. You know, why the fool's going out here in the rain? It makes no sense. Makes no sense at all. But now, since some of you have been here, y'all talking about my Hebrew heritage, right? You knew about that. You know, people are tracing their heritage all the time. Want to find out where they're from. And I was able to find out that my heritage goes back to the 6th century, back in with the Hebrews in Babylon. In Babylon. That was so cool to find that out, that some of my relatives were with Daniel while he was in captivity. That was so good. You might have heard of them. It was Shadrach, Meshach, and the big Negro. My ancestors, you know, heritage, it's important, you know, so, hey, that's what it is. That's what it is. But we're glad you're here. We're glad you're here. There are, you know, one thing that when I was over, I haven't had the privilege of going over to Egypt to do some training. I was over there for like a week and a half training some of the folks over there. And when you're around people, you know, people have different smells, different body odors. And I mean, sometimes somebody said, uh-oh, what are you going with this? What are you going with this? What are you doing? And it's based on the foods that they eat. Right? And we know that. We're in service sometimes. We walk up to our door and we can tell from the foods what type of folks are going to come. And I was saying, I'm wondering, what do folks say black people smell like? You know, my wife said, you might think they smell like fried chicken. I just wonder. I wonder if somebody said, I smell chicken. Is some black folks say it? You wonder. You have different smells, and there's nothing wrong. I mean, that's just part of the leeks and the onions and all the other things. You can tell where folks are from. And it's a wonderful thing to be able to enjoy the different personnel, the cultures and all like that. And we have many cultures here this evening. And we're welcoming you all. Welcoming you all. I'm glad you're here. We're going to get going pretty soon. The band's going to be coming in and coming down. And so, let's see. Tell you a little story. A little boy was walking along with a wagon full of puppies, newborn puppies. It's coming along and coming to a corner. And on the corner was this Catholic priest. And the Catholic priest said to the little boy, hey there, lad. Doing? What kind of puppies are there? Are those? And the little boy said, these are Catholic puppies. And the priest was, yeah, all right, good. And the little boy goes on about his way. And then the next week, little boys come along with this same little catch of puppies in a wagon, pulling them along, and the priest sees him, and he's down on the corner with another Catholic priest. And he says to him, Watch this. Young man, come over here. The little boy comes over. He says, tell my friend here, what kind of puppies are those? And he says, these are Jehovah's Witness puppies. He goes, what? I said, last week you told me they were Catholic puppies. He said, oh yeah, but now their eyes are open.
So they'll play 40, 50 minutes
so that you can enjoy the band, the full band. And then they'll have some dance music. And they'll play for a while, and then when they finally take a break, after a couple hours, then I will put some music on, and hopefully you'll stay on the dance floor. I don't call myself a DJ. I call myself a PJ. PJ, because, you know, DJs, they're mixing and doing all that stuff. I don't do that, because I want to dance. I'm a PJ. I have a playlist, and so I'll put together my playlist today, and we'll put it on. But if you have any requests for certain songs that you want, please find me. Tell me what those requests are. I probably won't play them. But you just feel good, you told me. You know, I feel good, but y'all told me what song I want. He ain't playing, but at least I told you what song I want. You know, I might have that. I might have that already in the playlist. We got a bunch of songs that we're going to play. And keep you on the floor. Keep you on the floor. We hope. We hope we'll do that. So. Oh, Kendall.
Is the city himself. My man on
lead guitar, the HMIC, that's head man in charge. Bruce, bass. What's up, bass man? Love you, brother. Take it.